Hello people, welcome back to the episode of Relating Me and You, You and Me through YouTube, and here I am with another video which is going to be again one brand tutorial which is going to be very very affordable and woman owned and made in India and everything good that you can think of. So this brand specifically we are talking about is Cuffs and Lashes. It's owned by Nidhi Katyar. She's a YouTuber if you don't know, but I will link her channel down below. And we have got our hands on few of the makeup products by Cuffs and Lashes. I have maximum products from them, but still there are a few here and there that are missing. So I will substitute those with other brands, but I'll try keeping it one brand with Cuffs and Lashes. So it's going to be full face of Cuffs and Lashes, one brand tutorial. And since we are doing one brand that's Indian or made in India, owned by an Indian woman, and since there is festive season coming along, I thought might as well do a festive look with this brand, right? With Cuffs and Tutorial. So it's going to be, you know, again, Cuffs and Lashes festive makeup tutorial. And this is the second episode of my Indian festive series. The first episode I will link here. You can go and check that out. I am making a playlist for that. And you can go and check that out too. And now without me talking too much, let's just directly get into the video. Let's begin. And as I said, I don't have everything from Cuffs and Lashes, or still there are a few things missing. So I don't have any eyebrow product by Cuffs and Lashes. You can definitely use their eyeshadow palette, which have a few brown shades, but the one that I have does not have a brown shade that would suit my eyebrows. So I'm going to substitute it with the other product, and the one that I'm using is NYX Tame and Frame brow pomade. I'm going to use this to do my brows. And let's just do it. And now after we have done our brows, I am going to proceed towards my face. And for that, I am going to use this PAC Zero Pore Separation Cream as my primer, because I did not really find any primer that belongs to Cuffs and Lashes. And this one is really nice and pore filling. So this works really well for my skin. I'm just going to apply it where I have huge pores. That's my nose and the region right here. You know, this is a perfect primer if you want to get rid of your texture, if you want to get rid of those pores or fill those pores. So this is a perfect primer for that. Your skin feels so smooth, so soft. And now when that primer is setting on place, I am going to proceed with my eyes first. That's a little different from my usual, but I want to do something really colorful. So I thought I might as well start with eyes first today. And I am going to use this eyeshadow guards here. I bought these from Amazon and they work really well. For eyeshadows, we are going to be using this palette right here. This is Cuffs and Lashes 9 color eyeshadow palette in the shade Kiwi, and this is how it looks like. So many beautiful shades, right? And it comes with the protection. The packaging is not the best, and we don't have a mirror here, but we understand why, you know. As you try improving packaging or adding mirror, all those things are just going to add to the cost. But if they want to keep the cost low, they have to make sure that they compromise on something. So instead of compromising on the quality of the shadows, they have just done it with the packaging, which I don't mind at all. If the shadows are really well performing and they show up on my eyes, I don't mind if the packaging is not the best in the world. So, and as you can see, this is the eye look we are going for. Very colorful, very beautiful. The eyeshadows are showing up so well. And the glitter, oh my god. The glitter shade right here is so reflective. If you're going for a nighttime look, this is going to show up really well. And you're going to really pop. Your makeup is going to really pop. Because the eyeshadows are very pigmented and the glitter is very, very, very reflective. And now let's move to the other eye and see how we do it. And to prime our eyelids, we are going to use this Cover Pot by Cuffs and Lashes. It's in the shade Cool Tan. And this is how the Cool Tan looks like. We are going to try this on our eyelid. By the way, the packaging, oh my god. Although it's not, you know, of the best quality, but look wise it looks very, very luxurious. I really love the packaging. It's very handy and, you know, let's see how the product performs. And now I'm going to apply this on my eyelid to prime my eyes and prepare them for the eye look. They are so creamy. The cover pots are really creamy and blend really well. You can see immediately it blended so well just with my finger. Wow. Now since this cover pots are that creamy, I really doubt how it is going to perform as a primer, because they might be best for concealing or foundation, but for eyeshadows, concealing, because we want to keep the oils at bay, right? That is why you apply an eyeshadow primer, so that the oil of our eyelids doesn't, you know, make everything crease. So let's see what it does. And to start with, I am going to take this dark shade, teal green shade, on a very, very small, let me just show, a really tiny pencil brush, because this is going to go in the crease, so this has to be very tiny. Yeah, let's just apply it on the crease now. I'm going to deposit it first on the crease, not doing anything else, just depositing the color. There's no blending going on here, okay? You just are depositing the color, and the pigmentation is really awesome. You can see it is showing up so well. And whenever you are trying to be more precise with your eyeshadow, hold it from the close and then apply it. That way you'll get really close to the eyeshadows and they'll get deposited really well. Because if you hold it from the far, you lose control actually and it goes into blending. But if you want to deposit it, I would suggest that you hold it a little closer and deposit it wherever you want. And I'm also going to deposit it on the outer third of my eyelid space. The eyeshadow doesn't look patchy. They are performing really well. And the pigmentation is showing up really well. Like, according to Indian standards, this is really good. Because I have not seen any Indian eyeshadows showing up. Like, the pigmentation is blah when it comes to Indian eyeshadows. I have not really seen one that performs well. And now, whatever is left, I am going to go to the inner corner and just, I am going to dab the color on the inner corner as well. Yeah, as I said that those cover pots are creamy, the oil is definitely showing through. So I would not suggest them as your concealers. And now let's use a little fluffy brush and go in with this lightest shade from the same color and just blend this out. The pigmentation is showing up properly, they are blending out well. I think I'm loving the shadows, but let's not be too quick. Is definitely looking really nice. You can see, right? I just hope the camera is doing justice to the colors, because the ombre is looking nice. And now I'm going to pick this glitter shade, and you can see it is so glittery and at the same time is not difficult to put on. Just dab it and it's right there. It transfers really well, but you know, not bad kind of transfer. With this glitter shade especially. You see how evenly the color is distributed? really nice. You know, this is what you have to look in an eyeshadow, that it deposits the color evenly, it doesn't turn out patchy. When you're transferring the glitter shade from your finger to your eyelid, it is depositing that color properly, like it is doing right here. You know, it deposited it all around very evenly, and it does not look like, you know, it has not spread it everywhere. So that's the best thing, that it is depositing where you want it to be. And now that's done, let's move towards eyeliner. And I am going to use this shadow palette again for the eyeliner, because the color of the liners that I have doesn't go very well with this look. It would look just very random with this eye look, so I'm not using those eyeliners. Instead, I am going to use this palette and draw an eyeliner like this one right here. So I'm taking an angled brush here, and I'm going to pick up this mehendi green shade, a very nice glittery mehendi green shade, not glittery, sparkly, you know, it has a little golden sheen to it, and it performs really well again because I did this side, so I know it's not like first impression. I already created this eye look off camera, so I know how it's performing, right? And now I'm just going to draw that eyeliner. On top of this glitter also, this color performs really well, because sometimes because of the glitter, when you try drawing an eyeliner with an eyeshadow, it does not show up. But this one, wow. And this is how it is looking. I am obsessed already. I am sure this look is going to turn out really well. And for my lower lash line, I'm going to repeat the same shades. I'm taking that darkest shade, eyeliner shade, and I'm going to deposit it on my lower lash line. And then taking a pencil brush and this lightest shade again, I'm just going to smudge it. And for that, we'll have to take this out actually. See, wow. That is why I love this. You know, I know many people use Sellotape, but I think this works really great because it's not that expensive. This eyeshadow guard, it's not that expensive, and also it does not harm your skin like a Sellotape would do. So that is why I would prefer this. And now I'm going to take that glittery shade again on pencil brush, and it transfers equally well with a pencil brush, and I'm just putting it on the inner corner and inner third of my lower lash line. And this is how everything is looking. I just applied mascara because I didn't have any from Cuffs and Lashes, so I just did it off camera. Now I'm going to get rid of all this glitter fallout that I had here. And now we are going to move towards the base, and I am going to start with concealing first. For that, I am using again Cover Pot by Cuffs and Lashes, and I am using the shade Nude. This is how the shade looks like, and I think this is going to be a really nice shade for my under eyes. So I am just going to pick up a little bit on my finger, because you know I like to use my fingers for this thing. Just going to blend it under my eyes. Again, as I said, very creamy, very hydrating, looks really nice. The color shade is really nice. I like that it melts into your skin immediately, and because it is so creamy and hydrating, your under eyes doesn't look, you know, it doesn't show too much of texture, it does not dry down your under eyes. I'm really liking this. You can see the difference, na? This just looks so much bright and beautiful. Definitely. Let's just do the other side. You can obviously use a beauty blender, you can use a brush for that matter, but I like using my finger under my eyes. That just, I think that just gives me more control. And because of the warmth of the body, it just performs better, I think. I'm liking that it has not turned everything cakey. It looks very natural. It looks very skin-like. I'm really liking that. I'm going to use this all over the center of my face, like I would do with any other concealer, to brighten the center a little bit. And now for the rest of the face, I am using the same cover pot, but it's in the shade Cool Tan, and I'm going to use a foundation brush here because we want to try how it looks with a brush. Blends really well into your skin. I hope you can see the difference, but it looks amazing. Blending out so easily. And this is how my full face is looking. I know the color is looking a little off, it looks a little light, but in real life it's looking just a perfect match. It looks really nice. And I like how it is looking very skin-like. I cannot stop obsessing about how much skin-like it is looking, right? And now I would like to pick up a little bit and see how we can build it up, because I would definitely want to see how buildable it is, because right now we just have one layer of it on, and it looks nice. And now let's try to build up this acne spot right here. You can see two acne spots because it's just one layer, so definitely they're going to peek through. But now just spot correcting them and trying to build it up a little bit to cover them. It does cover, definitely it does. Wow. Let me just blend the edges of this concealer. Really nice. Now this acne mark was really dark. I just hope you can see. This acne mark was really dark, so it has not covered it completely, but this one is completely covered. You know, because it's a bump, so it's visible, but other than that, there's no spot here visible. But this tiny spot is visible because the acne is really dark here, and I think it's pretty good. The pots are really, really good. And now let's proceed with rest of our base, and I'm going to start with blush here. Now why I am not powdering my face, that's because I've heard that these are self-setting and you don't really need a powder. So I want to see how that works and how it works without a powder. So I'm not going to set it on place. Instead, I'm going to use powder blush and powder contour just to, you know, give it a little bit of hint of powder so that it sets on place. If it is self-setting, this should work just fine. And for the blush, I am using again Cups and Lashes Cuppy Cake in the shade 20 something. The packaging looks a little flimsy, but again, I don't mind if the product is going to perform well. And you know what kind of blush holder I am. Let's see how that works, but to make sure it's not too pigmented, dabbing excess on the back of my hand, I think, is a good trick. Wow. The blush looks so nice. It is looking so nice. It's a teeny tiny bit more pigmented than I would like, but I don't mind if it blends. Let's see if it blends. It does. Let me tell you what I did. I deposited the blush here, right? And then because it was a little excess, I brought it down here, and that just worked very well. Really nice blush. Really, really nice blush. A very nice shade of pink. If you are my shade, I would definitely recommend this blush. And now let's move towards a bronzer or a contour, you might say. Again, Cuppy Cake. I don't know the shade names, they are not really written here. Let me see the packaging. No, can't find it. I will leave it in the description box in case you are interested. So I'm going to pick up this bronzer shade and let's see how it works. Okay, yeah. Very, very similar to blushes in terms of pigmentation and blending. Let's see if it gives that sculpt to my face. Oh, it does. Can you see? I can see it on my monitor here. This looks a little more angled. This one is drooping down because obviously I don't have a jawline. So, yeah, it definitely is making the difference. I think I would suggest this definitely for beginners. Because, you know, blending is one thing that can make or break your look. And I think if beginners get something that's easily blendable, they can easily create a very nice look. I like the products. And now that is all our face done, and let's proceed towards lipstick. And for lipstick I have this one. This is their Cuffs and Lashes Penta 5-in-1 matte lipstick, and it is that, you know, the lipsticks that Rene also introduced, but I like that they have a little bit of branding done here, and it's 5-in-1. I am not a very big fan of 5-in-1 because if you lose one, the others I don't know how we can use if you just by chance drop one or just lose one, so I'm not a very big fan of that. But okay, let's see how it works and let's see what shade I want to use. I'll go for the first shade only. Oh no 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 no. That's not the right shade for this look. Let's proceed to the next one. There was one nude variant and then there was one pink variant. I bought the nude variant. These shades are just not going to work with this look, I'm sure. Let's see the other one. Okay, let's just go with this. Very creamy. Our full face of Cuffs and Lashes One Brand tutorial. Now let's start understanding what works and what doesn't work here. Now let me tell you, I am already very sure it's been quite some time since I have worn these products right here, and they are looking pretty good. They're looking pretty good. The cover pots are performing very well. Nothing has broken until yet. Everything looks very nice. They definitely look a little oily around this region, but other than that, they're looking pretty good. They have not turned cakey. They have not turned, they have not creased like my under eyes. They're not creased. You know, I have not set them with powder, but still they have not creased. And I am liking that about it. Just little bit oil on my T-zone, which is usual because my T-zone is hell and oily, and if I set it with powder, I think it would be pretty good and it will be pretty long lasting. It's been 2.5 hours now that I have worn this makeup and I am already liking it. Everything is intact, everything is on place, nothing is budging, the blush is still showing up, the eyeshadows are still showing up. The only thing that I did not like here is the lipstick because I just don't like it. The formula is very, very creamy, but I am sure when I eat something or when I drink something, it's definitely going to vanish away. As usual, I keep dropping things. I don't like the lipstick because it does not give me as much control while applying it. It is just going everywhere. And I think if it's too hot, it's going to bleed out because I can already see it bleeding around the corners of my mouth because I usually sweat there a little bit. So this lipstick is a hard pass. But other than that, all other products, their formula and everything, whether it is their cupcakes, whether it is their cover pot, whether it is their eyeshadow palette, everything looks pretty good. Now I did not get to try their eyeliners, which I would definitely would like to try, but maybe in some other video, and we'll see how they perform. But till then, Cups and Lashes, I love them. You should definitely give it a try. Perfect for beginners because they are pocket friendly and they perform so well. Definitely should give it a try. And guys, this is the complete look. What are you thinking about it? You like it? You don't like it? Whatever it is, please drop it in the comment section below. And yeah, that's all for this video. If you like it, give it a big fat thumbs up. And if there is anything that you want me to make videos on, drop it in the comment section below. I'll be more than happy to do it. Until then, take care. Ta-da!